Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So hello and good afternoon students. We've already seen the whole chapter, the theoretical part, the numerical, the mathematical part, the efficiencies, the work done, the forces. Now let's apply all those things in the numerical. So we'll be talking about different numericals here in this section. So now let's take the next question, question 5 of centrifugal pumps. This question 5 is similar to the last question that we did. The value is changed, so it's just similar to the last question that we did now. So let me read out the question once again for you. Find the power required to drive the centrifugal pump which delivers 0.05 meter cube of water per second to a height of 22 meter through a 16 centimeter diameter pipe of 120 meter length. The overall efficiency of the pump is 70% and the friction factor is given as 0.015. So we need to calculate the power required to drive the pump. So how much power you need to supply to the pump so that it can deliver the water at a given value of H and with having certain value of losses, friction factors given to you. So let's first of all write down the given data and let's go on to solve the question then. So as we did in the last question, let's first of all find the value of the velocity of the flow in the pipe. So once we get the velocity, we can get the value of head loss because of friction. So after you solve this equation, you'll get the value of velocity of the flow, that is 2.48 meters per second. And after you get the velocity, let's go on to calculate the head loss because of friction. So head loss because of friction, that is HF, is equal to 4 FLV square upon 2GD that we've already studied in the later chapters. The friction factor is given to you. So we've got the value of velocity. Now using the equation, that's the equation, let's calculate the head loss because of friction. So here everything is known, you just need to multiply the numerator and then finally divide with the denominator. So the HF comes out to 14.3 meters. Now the head is already given through which the water has to be pumped, and this, the value of HF is come out to 14.3. So the overall head that the pump has to overcome is addition of both, because if you design a pump which can deliver a head of only, that is 22 meters, it cannot pump the water because it has to overcome friction as well. So we need to account all the heads, that is the friction, the friction head as well, and the head through which it has to pump. So the total head is nothing but the head through which the water has to be pumped and the friction head. So the total head is 36.3 meters. Now let's use the overall efficiency formula and we can get the value of shaft power. The value of discharge is given as 0.05. So once you multiply all the values in the numerator and then divide with 0.25, you'll get the value of shaft power as 23.74 kilowatts is the shaft power that has to be supplied to the pump so that it can raise the water to the through the given head. So that was all about this question. I hope you've understood this. Thank you.